Hey ladies, I'm Jenny, Jennifer Burns from MissingNailsPR.com. Jenny, yes, Jenny, Jen, Jen. They have a little touch of the beach, and I'm gonna share with you on how I did my own nails. Hey guys, so the first design I'm going to show you is, why am I doing this? I look like a rabbit. Rabbit. Okay, I'm not cutting this out. I'm going free as a clown like I usually am. I drive my kids totally nuts. Well anyways, back to the nails. Let's go back to the nails. I'm going to show you how I did my hairy bone design first with the spring colors. Now, this nail doesn't have anything to do with the beach. My other nails do. If you guys want to see the nails that I have, I did post them on Facebook at mysticnails.fan, so go ahead and go check them out if you want. And you guys can vote or ask me what designs you want next. So far for now, the next design after the hairy bone is going to be it's a seashell with a little seahorse in it. That I totally love that nail. I love it, I love it, I love it. But it's decapitated already because I cut my nails. They're all short. So let's get on with this design.
Okay, ladies. So we are going to use some pastel colors. I'm going to use yellow, blue, and pink. And my pink has a little bit of shimmer to it. I'm using Easy Flow colors. I will leave you the information of the colors and the names that I used in the description box down below. I'm using a number 12 Kolinsky brush, and as you can see, I am preparing these nails before I even put them on my finger. This is the design I'm going to use on my own nails, and I started off with some yellow, as you can see. Just grabbed a pearl of yellow and just grab it and place it over, like, on the middle section of your nail, just to divide it and drag it diagonally upwards. And you're going to keep building your design on either side, and you're always going to touch but overlap the color, but not having those colors go over or on top of your previous colors. So I'm going to use my pink right here on my side next to my yellow, and just clean off the very edge of your design. You can also do this just kind of design with your gel nails and even with fingernail polish. Okay, let's go back to our yellow. I'm going to place it at a diagonal once again from my other side. Now, I kind of left this a tad bit more towards the right side. On my left side of the nail instead of the middle of it. You start the division where you want it to be. Your lines can be a lot more thinner, a lot more thicker. They can be more colors. It can be less colors. It's all up to you what you would like to do. Now, for me, I'm just showing you how I am doing them on my own nails with these three colors you can see right here. And yes, those are little tiny seahorses and starfish and a little bit of sand from one of the beaches here in Puerto Rico. Now, once I get up to my smile line, I want that end of the acrylic that's kind of going to meet my smile line to be curved at my smile line. Now, after this acrylic has set with all these colors, I'm going to encapsulate what I have right now in transparent acrylic, ladies. Afterwards, I'm going to prepare my nail, and I will glue on my nail tip and then proceed to place the color of the acrylic that I want on my natural nail bed. And I am going to end up using my own color mix. As sometimes you guys ask me what color I use or where I get it. It's my own mixes that I do prepare for my nail beds. And all the colors I use, it all depends on my mood. If I'm into the brownish tones and the pink tones. So for these nails, I did use like a higher tone of pink. This is almost like a little Barbie pink. So just go, remember, prepare that nail bed adequately like you always do. And then just keep working your acrylic all over your nail bed. Just make sure you don't have that pink color go over your acrylic design. And just encapsulate with transparent acrylic. Afterwards, you're going to file your nail, you're going to buff it, and apply some top coat. And here is the finished result, ladies.
Tutorial I did last week wasn't exactly a nail art tutorial, but it was showing you how I prepare my own seashell mix. So if you guys missed it, I'll leave you the link down below. If you haven't participated in the giveaway, I will leave you the link to that video down below also. So next week I'll be showing you how I did my seahorse and starfish nails. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, go ahead and subscribe. I'm on Facebook. I'm always on Facebook at mysticnails.fan and on Instagram at mysticnails. Thank you for watching and sharing your time with me. I appreciate it from the bottom of my heart. And you guys, remember to always breathe in deep, have those happy thoughts, love, and relax. I will see you soon. Ciao.